This is a production of PBS 39.
Entrepreneurship is such a hot topic, and we want to learn a little bit more about it, and so I have a special guest joining me in the studio right now, Paul Brown. He's with Lehigh University and the College of Business and Economics. Paul, thanks so much for your time.
Thanks for having me.
Dr. Brown, help us understand, at Lehigh University, do you see, as someone who's worked in the area of entrepreneurism for years, what's the right age?
I think there really is no right age. I see entrepreneurs starting in high school. I see it in college. I see second career. I do think high school, though, and college is a really nice sweet spot. There's a lot percolating in the minds of those young kids, and they're ready to really think with a very different way, very critical thinking. So I think maybe high school and then into college, undergraduates, is a real sweet spot.
At Lehigh University, you have a variety of programs. Just give us a little bit of the gamut.
We do. We probably have over 20-some programs that I would say relate to entrepreneurship. You can take a minor in entrepreneurship. You can study anything at Lehigh, whether it be in business or engineering, but you can take a minor. We have many different design programs that relate to entrepreneurship. We have different programs that work with small business development centers related to entrepreneurship, graduates and undergraduates. But we have a real plate of activities right now in the area.
Do you think it's a mindset that if you don't, you have to be a bit of a risk taker, it seems, to go down the entrepreneur aisle?
I do think it's a mindset. I think it's a critical view of life. You want to make a change. You want to put together all these things you're studying. You want to see how they can combine and make a difference, whether it be in a product, whether it be in a service, whether it be serving a community, whether it be corporate outreach. I do think it's a mindset. Not everybody has it. But I think it's a wonderful way to tie together lots of different things.
From a teaching and instruction standpoint, what is the most important thing that you can teach these students to prepare them for lives as entrepreneurs?
That's a good question. It can be taught, but it really also demands the student to have a particular mindset. You can teach them the basic skills as to critical thinking. You can teach them how to tie together things like very basic skills into innovation and creativity. It really comes down to tying together different disciplines, different areas of study. And you do that with experiential learning, primarily. You put things right in front of them and say, build this, design this, think about how this could be changed. And you do it in the context of courses, but you actually try to tie together many different areas of study.
And you have several competitions that are geared and related to entrepreneurism, and that competition seems to be an important part. If you're out on your own with your own business and you don't have that competitive nature within you, how do your competitions prepare students for that?
We do have competitions, and competitions are fun. It allows the creative juices of the students to be channeled in the context of a marketing course or in the context of a product design, and they're asked to actually come up with something that they must, most importantly, present to outsiders, present to individuals from the Lehigh Valley, individuals that have been successful, and the competitions have winners and they have losers. And students love it. We love it. The donors love it. It's a way to get tremendous exposure for what we do within our courses.
Let's talk a little bit. You have something in the summertime for high school students from all across the Commonwealth.
We do. It actually starts, I believe, very soon. Pennsylvania Governorship School. What it's very much is about is bringing high school students to Lehigh. It's co-sponsored by the College of Business and Economics and the College of Education. And we bring these students here, and they operate in the context of a university setting, learning global entrepreneurship. It's a wonderful opportunity for high school students. The side benefit to Lehigh is we get these students exposed to a wonderful university.
And there's so much. As we wrap up, Paul, if you can tell us, what's kind of the one thing that young people need to grasp if they're going to go down this path?
I think they need to grasp change is natural, innovation is natural, creativity is natural, and you need a whole large set of skills to be able to make a difference. You need to be ready for uncertainty. You need to be ready to understand that you might be able to make a difference. There's going to be bumps. There's going to be changes. There's going to be activities you're not comfortable with. But you're going to have a mindset that you will be able to make a change.
Dr. Paul Brown from Lehigh University and the College of Business and Economics, thank you so much for your time and for your information.
Well, thank you very much.
Support for Tempo is provided by... building a workforce system called PA Career Link Lehigh Valley, training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs, connecting employers with workers, and workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.
RCN and RCN4, partnering with PBS 39 and committed to bringing quality local television programming to the residents of the Lehigh Valley. RCN, cable, phone, and internet.
And by the members of PBS 39, thank you.